At J.J. Mugg Stadium Grill in Jupiter, owner Dennis Witkowski has the obligatory sports pictures on the walls. But his personal sports story is as good as any of those in the frames. For two summers, Witkowski put on a uniform and traveled the world, playing against some other well-known Globetrotters, the Harlem Globetrotters.
We played 7 days a week. We played sometimes months at a time without getting a day off.
Witkowski had just graduated from Fordham University in 1969 and was tending bar in the Hamptons when a chance meeting with a former court competitor led to a phone interview with Red Klotz. Klotz owned a team best known as the Washington Generals.
Said, well, gee, you know, I'm looking for a center. Would you be willing to, you know, to join my troop? And he hired me on the phone.
Here was the program that summer in Germany.
Whether they were the Generals, the New Jersey Reds, the Chicago Demons, or the U.S. All-Stars on a particular night, Witkowski's team would always lose.
People always ask me, you know, how could you stand all that losing? I lost 500 straight games. I lost in 45 states and 15 countries.
Despite his record, Witkowski says they played hard. The games were 60% straight and 40% show.
Our joy was bringing a great show to the people, getting a reaction from the crowd, the laughs that you would get, the faces on the little kids.
But could they have beaten the Trotters?
The answer is definitely yes. We had excellent athletes. We had some top-notch college ball players. And I honestly believe we would have beat them two nights a week if it was a straight game.
Meadowlark Lemon and Curly Neal were the most recognizable figures, and in the early 70s, the Trotters were probably at their peak popularity. It was one big family.
We traveled together. We stayed in the same hotels together. We went to the same parties together. Here we are at Wembley.
The Globies and the Generals once played 10 games in 7 days at Wembley Stadium in London in 1970. The games were broadcast live on the BBC three straight nights. A big deal since it wasn't until 1973 when the Globetrotters began making regular appearances on ABC's Wide World of Sports. Witkowski says his side got more respect overseas, where the Globetrotters were thought of as the best basketball team ever.
And we would lose 110 to 106. And they thought we were the second greatest team in the world.
But after 500 games in 2 years, the 6'8 center decided to try life in the pros stateside. He was cut from the Pittsburgh Pipers of the old ABA and played a few more years professionally in the Eastern League before moving on to the restaurant business. J.J. Muggs is the seventh restaurant Witkowski has successfully run. He looks back with pride at his time as a Globetrotter foil. He believes the Trotters broke down a lot of color barriers.
Sam Sawyer and I were roommates in Europe, and it was the summer of 70, and we were actually the first interracial pairing of roommates in the history of the Globetrotters.
When you hear Sweet Georgia Brown, that brings you good memories, right?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's a song that you heard constantly. Once you're part of the Globetrotter family, you're always part of the Globetrotter family. People constantly want to talk about it, and I'm always happy to oblige.
Outside of the Fat Albert theme, I challenge anyone to find a better opening cartoon theme song than the original Harlem Globetrotters cartoon. Believe it or not, Witkowski was a member of the Washington Generals team that actually beat the Trotters in Tennessee in 1971. However, he told me he asked for the night off to spend another day with his family, so he was not in the arena that night. John Shainman, WPBF News 25.